Welcome, dear listener, to this intoxicating episode called Tequila Tomes, pouring shots of bookish wisdom, shaken, not stirred. I'm your host, Evie, and tonight we're delving into the world of love, courtship, and marriage through the lens of tequila and Jane Austen's classic, Pride and Prejudice. This is Books and Cocktails, a podcast where we mix the literary and the libations for the soft and easy connoisseurs of life. So grab your favorite tequila and let's start pouring shots of bookish wisdom. Our lineup for tonight's episode, we have no other than Mr. Darcy, Mr. Bingley, Mr. Wickham, Mr. Collins, and Mr. Bennett, each a character worth examining when it comes to matters of the heart and the kind of modern men they each represent. This should be very exciting. Okay, ladies, get ready to be swept off your feet, because first in line is none other than the enigmatic Mr. Darcy. Okay, so picture this, a modern gentleman, mysterious and brooding, much like Mr. Darcy. He's not your typical swipe right material, okay? He's the kind who leaves you intrigued, sipping your metaphorical tequila, okay? So, what can we learn from Mr. Darcy about the type of man worth pursuing? Lesson number one, pride, prejudice, and patience. Mr. Darcy, you see, teaches us that love is a slow burn. He evolves as a proud figure to a humble, patient lover. Okay, so in today's fast-paced world, finding a man with the grace to let love simmer is a rare gem indeed. Okay, so lesson number two. Confidence, not arrogance. Mr. Darcy exudes confidence without arrogance. In a sea of overconfident swaggers, seek the man who speaks volumes through his actions, not just his words. It's about substance over style. Lesson number three, social grace. You see, ladies, Mr. Darcy navigates society with finesse. In our digital age, finding a man who can hold his own in a room full of strangers is a must. No one wants a Mr. Awkward when charming sophistication is on the menu. Should I increase the volume, ladies? Should I? And now we move on to lesson number four, okay? And it looks a lot like loyalty and integrity. You see, Mr. Darcy's loyalty to Elizabeth, despite society expectations, is a testament to his integrity. Seek a man whose loyalty is unwavering and whose moral compass points nowhere else but true north. Okay, let's move on. Next Next, ladies, we divert our focus to the amiable Mr. Bingley, a man whose affable nature conceals layers of complexity, just like the tequila in our glasses. He may go down smoothly, but beware, for beneath that charming exterior lies a blend of qualities that warrants caution. In matters of the heart, Mr. Bingley embodies the modern man who exudes warmth, generosity, and a penchant for social gatherings. But, much like tequila, his influence can be intoxicating. Ladies, be wary of mistaking his easy charm for genuine commitment. While he may pour shots of kindness, does he really possess the maturity and resilience needed for the long haul of marriage? Does he? Now let's sip on the pages of Pride and Prejudice to decipher Mr. Bingley's traits. You see, his quick infatuation with Jane Bennet serves as a lesson, a reminder that rapid romantic enthusiasm may lack the depth required for enduring love, a cautionary tale for those who might be swept away by the initial sparkle only to find the substance lacking. Maybe I should increase the volume a wee bit. You see, Mr. Bingley's susceptibility to external influence, particularly from his friend Mr. Darcy, warns us of the importance of individual discernment. Ladies, in the dance of courtship, ensure your partner is not easily swayed by external opinions or societal pressures. A man of substance remains steadfast, true to his convictions and unswayed by the winds of societal expectations. Yes, I said it. As we clink our glasses to Tequila Tomes, let's appreciate the lessons from Mr. Bingley's character. A reminder that, in love and life, a careful blend of charm, discernment, and resilience is essential. So, honey, sip your metaphorical tequila slowly, relishing the layers of wisdom within each page, and navigate the dance of love with a discerning heart. In third place, we have Mr. Collins, the peculiar kind. Let's zoom him in. A modern-day Mr. Collins, a man whose love strategy is as baffling as his choice of conversation topics. Draining, right? Mr. Collins, you see, is the epitome of obsequiousness and social awkwardness, and boy does he become a cautionary tale. As we peer into his misguided attempts at romance, we unravel the lessons he imparts. It's a concoction of pride, misplaced confidence, and an utterly cringe-worthy proposal. Imagine encountering a modern-day Mr. Collins. He's the guy who inundates or floods your inbox, if you like, with unsolicited poetry, tells you how much he likes you before the first date, and proposes with a PowerPoint presentation. My goodness! These traits make him a perilous companion, and you should therefore be mindful of him because he's the typical sweet talker, you know? The kind that makes his way to your heart with nothing but words. Mr. Collins' pursuit of love is clearly misguided, And this is why I'm urging you, ladies, to discern between genuine affection and superficial charm. So listen on as you sip on your favorite cocktail, whether shaken or stirred. As we read on, we encounter the charming yet treacherous Mr. Wickham. You know, his name kind of rhymes with wicked, as in Wicked Wickham. Anywho, picture him as the modern day man who sweeps you off your feet with a charismatic smile and smooth words. But ladies, beneath the polished surface lies a cautionary tale for the unwary. Mr. Wickham's character unveils the layers of deception and manipulation. We draw parallels to contemporary situations, identifying the telltale signs of a modern-day Wickham, the kind of man who might lead you astray with promises that glitter but hold no substance at all. As we sip on our tequila-infused wisdom, we unravel the lessons from Elizabeth Bennet's experience. What seemed like a romantic adventure turned into a cautionary tale about discernment and the importance of seeing beyond the facade. Through engaging anecdotes and witty insights, we discuss the pitfalls of being enamored by charm alone. Our Tequila Tomes guide us through the maze of emotions, urging caution when a modern-day Wickham whispers sweet nothings. So ladies, pour yourself another shot of wisdom as we navigate the intricate dance of love, courtship, and marriage, learning from the missteps of Elizabeth and the charming deceiver. Finally, we dissect the enigmatic Mr. Bennet. He's not just a character, you see. He's a cocktail of quirks, wisdom, and maybe, just maybe, a splash of indifference. Mr. Bennet, a man whose wit is as sharp as a lime wedge, but whose romantic strategy might leave you with a hangover. In love, courtship, and marriage, should you be wary of this literary figure? Let's explore. In the courtship dance, Mr. Bennet's wit is like a well-aged tequila. Charming, but be cautious, for his sarcasm may sting like a shot of the finest spirits. But not all that glitters is gold, and Mr. Bennet's nonchalance could be the bitter aftertaste you weren't expecting. Now, let's move beyond the ballroom and into the realm of modern-day relationships. Mr. Bennet, an archetype of his time, may still linger in the present day, a man who, beneath a facade of humor, hides a reluctance to engage deeply with matters of the heart. Ladies and gentlemen, especially the ladies, in matters of marriage, is Mr. Bennet the guide we need or the cautionary tale we should heed? You see, his aloofness, perhaps a reflection of societal expectations, still echoes in the contemporary world, urging us, you know, to question the role we play in our relationships. As we sip our metaphorical tequila, let's remember the lessons from Pride and Prejudice. Don't be swayed by charm alone. Look beyond the surface for a love story crafted with depth and sincerity. As we conclude our tequila fuel journey into the world of Pride and Prejudice, remember, finding a modern day Mr. Darcy might be like discovering a rare bottle of aged tequila worth savoring. So, my darling ladies, keep your standards high, your glasses full, and may your love story be as timeless as a classic novel. Until next time, this is Books and Cocktails. Signing off. Cheers.